Hey guys, it's Ivan or Dreamframer again, and today I'm gonna teach you how to turn a flat looking image into an image full of details. Sometimes you can't choose the day when you're gonna take a photo of a landscape. The weather can be cloudy, the light will be very diffuse in that case, and as a final result, the photo will look flat, with lack of shadows, with lack of color, and the sky might look completely blown out, white, with no details. We can fix this, and to do it, I'm gonna use Photoshop CC, mostly camera raw filter in it. But if you're using any other software, I'm gonna do my best to explain each of those steps that I'm applying, so you can hopefully find similar filters in your software to match the result. The photo that I'm using for this tutorial was provided by a photographer named Haley. The original photo was posted on Reddit, and I gave you the link down there in the description so you can check it out. And this way, I want to say again, thank you, Haley, for letting me use your photo in this video. If you guys like this video, be sure to press that like button or subscribe to my channel. That's what really motivates me to make more of these tutorials. I'm also making another series of videos with a subject on how to sell your photos online. And if that's something that interests you, subscribe, because I can promise you this is going to be the most detailed guide on YouTube on how to do this and how to start making money by selling photos online. And now let's try to improve that flat looking image. The picture is obviously taken on a cloudy day. There is some fog going on here. The sky is completely blown out because the camera tried to adjust the exposure to the larger part of the image, which is basically rocks and moss and trees. And that's the reason why we can't see any details in the sky. The sky is completely blown out. In addition to that, there is no any sunlight, so shadows are really flat. And we'll try to correct that, to add some deeper shadows, to add some more details and add some color and fix this sky. The first thing I want to do is copy this layer. I'm gonna do that by dragging it down to the new layer icon. And while the top layer is active, I want to fix this bridge that is not really horizontal. I hope you can see that. I'm gonna turn on the grid so you can see the grid lines. And now you can clearly see when I zoom in that grid lines are not parallel to the bridge. So I'm gonna fix that by going to the edit menu while the top layer is active and go to transform, select skew. I'm gonna grab this middle point over here and drag it up until the bridge is parallel to these grid lines. A little down maybe. That's about it. I'm just gonna click up here this check mark to confirm and turn off the grid. And now I can see some double objects here, and that's because the top layer is shifted and the bottom layer stayed intact. So I will switch off the visibility for the bottom layer so we can see this gap here and fix it. I can fix this with a spot healing brush, but I don't like to use spot healing brush on big areas like this. So I used selection tool to select the bottom of the image, but I didn't select the bridge because I need to stretch this part down to cover at least some of this gap, and I don't want stretching to affect the bridge. So I'm gonna go up here, click edit, transform and scale, and then drag this a little bit down until I cover at least some of this gap. That's about it. I'm gonna confirm, deselect by going to select and deselect. Just to mention, you can also deselect by clicking Ctrl D or Command D on the keyboard. And it would be good to learn these shortcuts because they can really speed up the process of image editing. So now I'm gonna use Spot Healing Brush. Adjust the size of it and get rid of this thing first. I don't know what it is. And then maybe even this, because it's right on the edge of the image. And then I'm gonna zoom a little bit to see what I'm doing here and use spot healing brush to cover this gap as well. I can still see some double leaves, but for this tutorial I'm not gonna play a lot with it. You can make this look more realistic. I'm gonna zoom out now and I'm gonna copy this layer by dragging it down to a new layer icon or clicking Ctrl J or Command J on the keyboard. And I'm gonna use Camera Raw Filter to fix contrast and colors and everything else we were talking about. This gap over here is actually not visible in our image, and it's here because we shifted the layer when we corrected the bridge. Camera Raw still shows this part even though it's actually outside of the image. So first I'm gonna increase the contrast a little bit, not too much though. And then I'm gonna go and pump up the lightest tones first, and then add some clarity to the image to bring back these details in this part where the rocks are. The clarity slider increases something that's called local contrast, which really helps with areas where you have textures, where you have small areas of light and dark, and you need to increase the contrast between them. So you can see if I move this slider on the left, the picture becomes more flat. If I move it on the right, then it brings more details to the picture. But this slider also desaturates colors, so we have to bring back some of the colors. The best way to do that is to use this vibrance slider, because vibrance increases the intensity or the saturation of the colors that are muted and leaves saturated colors intact or almost intact. So we can use this slider to move it more on the left or the right, depending on the desired effect we want to achieve. And if we use saturation slider, then the picture becomes too saturated. So be careful with saturation slider, move it maybe up to 10%. Usually you don't need more than that. So now I want to get rid of this fog a little bit, and for that I'm going to use this effects tab, and there is a slider that's called dehaze. If you move it to the right, you can see that the fog disappears but the picture becomes darker. So I'm going to go back to the basic tab and just bring back some light to the shadows and also to the darkest tones. Now I want to desaturate yellow a little bit, but I want to keep these green tones, especially green tones in these conifer trees, because these trees were really gray before. The moss in front has a lighter green color, which tells me that this green is actually mixed with yellow. So I'm just gonna go here to the Hue, Saturation and Lightness tab and use the Saturation tab to desaturate yellow. So I'm gonna pull this slider to the left, and you can play more with these sliders. You can change the hue of some colors, you can make these yellow leaves completely orange, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna try to bring up some green and bring down some yellow, and that's about it. I'm going back to the basic tab, and if I'm happy with the result, and I am, I'm just gonna go back to Photoshop by clicking OK. You can play more with this as I mentioned, but for this tutorial this is more than enough. So now you can see that the effect is applied, and if I switch off the visibility of this layer, you can see the bottom layer. So this is before and after. You can see how many details we added to the top layer. Let's replace this blown out sky now. To do that, I prepared another picture, which is just the sky. I took it from my old picture. I'm gonna select the whole image and click Ctrl C or Command C to copy it. Or you can do the same thing by going to Edit and Copy. And then I'm gonna go back to our picture, select the top layer, click Ctrl V or Command V or Edit Paste, and I'm gonna move this part of the sky to the top. I just want to mention one thing. When you're choosing the sky from another picture to cover the sky on your picture, you have to find the sky that matches the weather. So don't choose a sunny sky for the cloudy picture. It's not gonna look natural. Anyway, to reveal the trees, I have to change the blending mode of the layer with the sky to a darker color. This blending mode, when applied to the top layer, will allow darker colors from the bottom layer to be seen through the top layer. In this case, we have trees that are darker than the sky. They are below the layer with the sky, and that's why now we can see them. However, there is some unnatural edge around the tree on the left and the tree on the right. And I'm gonna fix that by changing the opacity of the top layer. So I'm gonna decrease the opacity to something like this. And now the sky looks more natural, and we got rid of that unnatural looking edge. I also wanna get rid of the sun because we don't have any shadows here, and it wouldn't be really okay to have the sun in the picture. It doesn't look really natural. So I'm gonna select this part of the image where the sky is while the sky layer is active, and stretch it so I get rid of the sun. I'll move it down a little bit. That's good. And now I'm just gonna deselect. Control D, there you go. Now I want to apply a mask to this layer just to make sure that nothing from the sky is visible through these rocks. So I'm gonna click here on the quick mask icon, select the mask, and use a black brush to paint over the parts where the rocks are and also the waterfall. There is nothing really that goes through these rocks from the sky, but I just want to make sure. I don't want to miss anything. And that's about it. This is almost done. The only thing that I want to do now is maybe add some vignette. And there are many ways to do this. You can even paint the vignette with a brush, but for now I'm just gonna select two top layers, go to layer menu, click merge layers, and go to camera raw filter again, because it's easy and simple to add a vignette over there. It's not the most creative or most flexible way, but for this tutorial it's gonna be enough. So I'm gonna click the lens correction tab and just add some vignette. Not too much though. Actually, I can go all the way left to left, maybe here. This looks good. Okay, going back to Photoshop. And now let's see before and after. I'm gonna turn off the middle layer. So this was before, and this is after again. Before and after. I'm sure you'll agree that we added a lot of depth and color to the image. I hope you liked this video, guys. If you did, be sure to press the like button. You can subscribe to my channel if you want to be informed about new tutorials that I'm making, and I'm gonna try to do them weekly or maybe twice a week. And if you have any questions, please post a comment or send me an email. Ask me about the problematic picture and I'm gonna do my best to try and explain you how to fix it. Or if you want, you can give me a picture and I can make a video tutorial on it. For now, this is it, and see you in the next video. Bye.